Sometimes we might find it hard to get up for work at a job we don't enjoy. But in comparison to some of the things people had to go through in the past, your typical 9-to-5 job might not seem all that bad. This is 5 of the worst jobs in history. Number 5. Match Girl. During the Industrial Revolution, the factories of London that manufactured matches often used to hire mainly young girls between the age of 13 and 16 years old to dip short sticks of wood into a phosphorus solution. At first, the idea of making simple matchsticks doesn't seem terrible, but the chilling thing that makes this one of the worst jobs ever was what happened after they'd been working in the factory for a few years. Working without proper safety equipment and inhaling the phosphorus caused an ailment known as phossy jaw. The gums of the person would begin to abscess and give off a foul-smelling discharge of pus. Over time, absorption of enough of the phosphorus destroyed the jawbone, causing extreme pain from the bones beginning to rot and die, as well as their jaw to take on a strange glow. The only known treatment at the time was a primitive surgery to remove the dead jawbone, leaving the disfigured patient scarred for life and with extreme difficulty eating, often leading to malnutrition. Number 4. Gong Farmer. Before modern sewage disposal systems, a gong farmer was a term that entered use in Tudor England to describe someone who dug out and removed human excrement from public outhouses and cesspits in the cities. Gong farmers were only allowed to work at night, so they were often known as nightmen. The waste they collected, known as night soil, had to be taken all the way outside the city or town boundaries to be disposed of. Much of the contents of London's cesspits was taken to dumps on the banks of the River Thames, such as the appropriately named Dung Wharf. Some of the dumps became quite massive. Mount Pleasant in present-day Clerkenwell, London, occupied a huge area of 7.5 acres by 1780. The penalties for not disposing of waste in the approved manner could be harsh, however. One London gong farmer who poured his farm down a drain was put in one of his own pipes and filled up to his neck with human excrement, before being publicly displayed in Golden Lane with a sign detailing his crime. Number 3. Petardier. Jokingly named by the French soldiers who used it, the device called a petard is derived from the Middle French word pater, meaning to fart. Petards were often a large bell-shaped metal case filled with gunpowder and fixed to a wooden frame. The base was attached to the wall or gate by the attacking army while besieging an enemy castle, and the bell shape of the iron case caused the explosion to travel directly in one direction at the target, to inflict maximum damage. Petarders often being sent in by themselves as a small team, with little more protection than an ordinary soldier, they would be lucky to make it to the enemy's walls at all, especially as the second the defender spotted them they would become the focus of huge amounts of musket and arrow fire. While operating these hugely dangerous and unstable devices, they were just as likely to kill themselves as to destroy the enemy's fortifications. This is why the phrase, hoist by your own petard, meaning to be foiled by your own plan, comes from the prevalence of petarders being blown up by their own explosives. Number 2. Wool Fuller. Wool was a massive part of the medieval European economy, and in 1300 there were around 15 million sheep in England alone, outnumbering humans in the kingdom 3-to-1, and creating jobs for thousands of people. After the initial shearing process, the wool needed to be cleaned, stripped of grease and other impurities. The cleansing process was particularly stringent using a strong alkaline liquor, but with the massive quantities of wool needing to be cleaned, other less sanitary liquids were used as a substitute. The job of a wool fuller required marching on the spot in a vat from morning till night. It was a boring and tiring job, made worse by the new liquid being used to remove dirt and grease from the wool, stale human urine. Turning the wool fuller's job into tramping all day with their feet soaked in old urine, the fumes filling the person's nose, and this new cheaper substitute staining their skin yellow. Number 1. Plague Bearer. Between 1346 and 1353, the plague or the Black Death is estimated to have caused over 100 million deaths in Eurasia and North Africa. This led to required nighttime collections and burials of victims by the cartful. A profession that arose from this deadly time was called the plague bearer. Local churches hired plague bearers, who toured the streets at night collecting the dead and depositing them in mass graves in churchyards and later massive burial pits outside large cities. the plague bearers spent their nights around plague victims and their rotting corpses, risking their lives and the lives of anyone they contacted. As a result, their days were spent in quarantine within the churchyard, surrounded by those same bodies they had previously buried, isolated and surrounded by death as they were not allowed to leave during the day so as to avoid infecting others. The close proximity to the dead and dying would cause many of the plague bearers to be killed by the very plague they were profiting from, ensuring they died in loneliness and isolation during their daytime quarantine. That was 5 of the worst jobs in history. Thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this one.